10, the reaching the age of adolescence. Hope you all remember the points. What is adolescence? Changes at puberty. Various changes will be seen during puberty. Then we saw about the endocrine glands. We remember what is an endocrine gland? The gland that secretes a chemical substances called hormones. So, endocrine glands, they secrete hormones. Hormones are nothing but the chemical substances secreted in the body. That is very essential for carrying out various metabolic activities. So, these hormones are secreted in the endocrine glands. This endocrine glands is otherwise called as ductless glands because what they secrete, that hormones are released, but they don't have any pathway to reach the place where it has to function. Then how it will be carried to different parts of the body? The hormones that are secreted in the endocrine glands will be carried by the bloodstream. The blood is circulated throughout the body, is it not? So, along with the bloodstream, the hormones will not be carried from the endocrine gland to the place where it is needed. So, the place where these hormones have to act upon, that is called as target site. So, from the endocrine glands, the secreted hormones will be carried by the bloodstream to the target site where these hormones should be functioned. And this target site will respond to the hormones and help in various activities. And these endocrine glands, there are many endocrine glands in our body. In the case of you, there is first one is pituitary gland. Pituitary gland is otherwise known as what? Master gland, as it controls all other endocrine glands in our body. This is the master gland which controls all other endocrine glands. So it is also called as master gland. And this endocrine gland is located in the head. It is present in the head. And it secretes two hormones. That is, what are those two hormones? FSH and growth hormone. FSH and growth hormone. So these are the two hormones secreted by the pituitary gland. FSH is nothing but the follicle stimulating hormone. This only stimulates the reproductive organs to produce the gametes. And growth hormone, it controls all various metabolic activities and it regulates the growth of the body. Next one, thyroid gland. It secretes a hormone called later. So that hormone is otherwise called as emergency hormone, which will adjust to our psychological feelings. That is why it is called as emergency hormone. Next one, pancreas. It is another endocrine gland which secretes insulin. And it is located above the stomach. Sorry, below the stomach. It is located below the stomach. Then, apart from that, testes, the reproductive organs like testes, they secrete testosterone. They secrete testosterone and ovary.
Five. After that,
which is responsible for the formation of different parts. But this last pair, two chromosomes, is responsible for the allosomes. It is called as allosomes, that is responsible for the determination of the sex, whether the baby is male or female. That is what we are going to see, how it is taking place. Now, so do you understand about these autosomes and allosomes? In the 23 pairs, 22 pairs are responsible for the formation of the body parts, and one pair is responsible for the formation of the sex of the baby. So, from what it has the fertilization, after the fusion of the sperm and egg, for example, this is the sperm, it contains 23 pairs. And let this be the egg. And this contains 23 pairs. In this, 22 plus, in case of male, this is male, this is female. In case of male, 22 plus that one chromosome may be either X or Y. X or Y. In males, the chromosome is two types of chromosomes are present. One is X or Y. But in case of females, 22 plus that last pair is both or X only. Only X chromosome is present in case of female, but in case of male, both X or Y is present. Now, during the fusion of the sperm and the egg, the chromosomes, they fuse in such a way that if X chromosome of male and X chromosome of female end. Next, about the sex determination of a baby. That is, in case of male and female, both have 23 pairs of chromosomes. During fertilization, the chromosomes, the male chromosome have two types. That is, it may contain either X or Y chromosome. And during fertilization, if the X chromosome of male fuses the X chromosome of the female, the resulting baby will be a girl child. That is, it will have both the X chromosomes. If the fusing chromosomes of male is Y and it fuses with the X of female, the resulting baby will be a male, that is XY. Like this only, the sex is determined in case of a baby. Next, the role of hormones in case of insects. How the hormones have effect in case of insects? That is what we are going to see. This is now. Role of hormones in case of insects. So, in the previous chapters that we discussed about the metamorphosis. What is that metamorphosis? Metamorphosis. That is, during the life cycle of the insects, it undergoes several changes. That is, from the larva to adult. In case of fertilizing a butterfly, frog and all you have studied. That is, after the hatching of egg, the young one coming out of the egg is called nymph, and it will not look similar to that of the adult. I hope you all remember. And it undergoes several changes to reach that adult stage. So such changes during the life cycle of the insects is called metamorphosis. And this metamorphosis is controlled by the hormone called insulin. in frog. You all know that they are frog lay eggs in water. After the hatching out of the tadpole from the egg, it undergoes several changes to reach the adult stage. That is called metamorphosis. And this metamorphosis, during the change of larva to adult, that is controlled by thyroxin. In case of frog, metamorphosis is controlled by the thyroxin hormone. In case of humans, the thyroid gland is present in the neck region and it secretes the thyroxin hormone. If it is not secreted in a proper manner, it will lead to a disease called goiter. But in case of frog, the metamorphosis is controlled by the thyroxin hormone. If the thyroxin is not secreted properly, it is not formed. For this formation of thyroxin, iodine is very important. If in the water this iodine is not present, then the thyroxin production will not be normal and that larva will not turn into adult. The growth will not take place. So the presence of iodine in the water is very important for the production of thyroxin. Then only the larva will change into adult. So like this, the hormones also have a role in case of insects. Understand? Next. Health for adolescents. The next topic is health for adolescents. The next topic is about the role of hormones in insects. Next one is reproductive health or health for adolescents. So you know that a lot of changes will take place during the adolescent period. Body changes will take place. Onset of puberty, after that body undergoes several changes. A rapid growth could be visualized. You can see lot of changes. For this growth of the body, you need a perfect nutritious food. That is, you need a balanced diet. What is balanced diet? In the right classes, you have studied all the nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals. Everything should be present in the food what we take. That is the balanced diet. Because different nutrients have different roles in our body growth. So, in order to satisfy the needs for the growth of the body, we should be conscious in taking the food which contains a balanced diet. That is, not only that carbohydrates, proteins, fats, iron, vitamins and minerals, iron. That is present in raw vegetables, green leafy vegetables, jaggery and all, iron content is more. Like this, lot of vitamins and minerals is also responsible for the vision, then growth of the hair, a perfect sight and all. So all the nutrients are necessary. And in this stage, you may be attracted by those junk foods. And you know that junk foods cannot replace the nutrients of that diet. We cannot replace the junk foods for a balanced diet, for a perfect meal. You may have the feeling of getting the tummy filled with the junk foods. But it is not be enough for the body growth. So different nutrients are also essential for the body growth. Like a packed food items, then noodles, what is that, fried items and all, you may take, but not often. Even though if you take that, it should not replace your regular diet. Because nutrients are very essential for your body growth at this stage. Understand? So like this, and also apart from that hygiene, personal hygiene, we call it as personal hygiene. That is, hygiene means what? Cleanliness. As the body undergoes various changes, one of that is increased activity of sweat and sebaceous glands. Increased activity. impactful. And there is a chance for using the drugs also. So what is drug? What is drug? Drug is nothing but the chemical substance that produce physical or mental or emotional changes in user. By using the drugs, drug is nothing but the chemical substance which brings the changes in physically or mentally or behavioral changes in the user. And using this drug apart from the medicinal use. So why these drugs are produced means for the medical purpose only they are producing this. But the people are using this in a wrong way. So using these drugs apart from the medicinal use is called drug abuse. Drug abuse. That is other than medical use. Other than medicinal use, we are using them for our own purpose. Without the advice of anyone, doctors or anyone, we are using the drugs other than medicinal use. It's called drug abuse. And those who are using those drugs will get depend on them frequently. They will depend on the drugs. Without that, they cannot do anything. They will become regularly using the drugs. So such condition is called as addiction. Such condition is called addiction. And this drug abuse is common in case of adolescents throughout the world. Because they are in the confused state and in the insecure feeling. Because of the insecure feeling they have, they are led to astray. And they become addicted to this usage of drugs. Examples are tobacco products like the cigarettes, alcohol, then cocaine, marijuana. So cigarettes, cocaine, marijuana. Then alcohol. So these are some examples for the drugs to which the people get addicted. Then you may suffer a lot because of using this. So you have to say no to these drugs. You should never use this. So whenever you get depressed or in a confused state, you should have a healthy discussion with your elders or parents or with your friends. And you should get clarified and you should not move to such a condition like addiction and all or using of the drugs and all. Apart from this, there is a deadly virus called HIV is there, which leads to a disease called AIDS because of the using of the syringes. If you may use syringes for these drugs and all, for taking the drugs. If a group of persons use the syringes means, then it will lead to the cause for the disease called AIDS, which is caused by a deadly virus called HIV. So all these possibilities are there, which may lead to a lot of sufferings. So you have to say no to the drugs. So these are the several changes which takes place in the adolescent stage, and what will be the result of that if you get confused and if you move to a wrong way. You the food without nutrients, and the growth may not be proper. So these are the steps how you should be careful in this stage to lead a healthy life. So the, with this, this chapter gets over, and we discussed a lot of points in this lesson. There is what is adolescence, changes in puberty, about the endocrine glands, role of hormones, reproductive phase in humans, sex determination in humans, the role of hormones in insects, then reproductive health. In that, we discussed how we should take care of your health, how we should take care of the personal hygiene, how we have to take that balanced diet, everything we discussed. Then say no to drugs. In say no to drugs, we discussed about what is a drug. It's a chemical that which brings changes physically, mentally, or emotionally in the user. Then drug abuse. Drug abuse means using the drugs other than the medicinal purpose, for our own purpose, without any medication, without any prescription. Using the drug will lead to addiction. That is called drug abuse. And then examples, few examples for drugs also we saw. So we should avoid all these things, and we should lead a good health, lead a life with good health. Hope you all understand. And with this, I'll send the worksheet and the classwork also.